Hello, welcome to question and answer session. Today we'll be dealing the remaining current affairs in November month. So this will be approximately around the dates from 21st to the month ending 30th. So irrespective of the dates, let us see. What is the theme of 12th World Congress on Mountain Medicine held in Kathmandu? It is Mountain Medicine in the Heart of the Himalayas. Mountain Medicine in the Heart of Himalayas is the theme of 12th World Congress on Mountain Medicine, which is held in Kathmandu. International Society for Mountain Medicine, for the first time in Nepal, has conducted a World Congress of Mountain Medicine. So this is a biannual event. It mainly focuses on science and research aspects of high altitude medicine. So coming to Kathmandu, we know it is the capital of Nepal and the currency is Nepalese rupee. The Prime Minister of Nepal is Khadga Prasad Oli. Khadga Prasad Oli. Reserve Bank of India has decided to set up an expert committee to examine the central bank's economic capital framework to enable transfer of reserve worth 3.6 lakh crore rupees to which organization? To Government of India. So Reserve Bank of India has decided to set up an expert committee. So it is thinking to transfer 3.6 lakh crore rupees to Government of India to examine the economic capital framework ECF. So for this it is thinking to set up a committee, and therefore the transfer of money hence will be decided. So Government of India as well as RBI, both of them, they'll be jointly deciding the members of the committee, and henceforth they'll be putting forward the issue. Which of the following countries refused to sign a United Nations pact on migration because the agreement would undermine their existing immigration policies? Australia and Poland. Australia and Poland, both of them, they have refused to sign a United Nations pact on migration because the agreement would undermine their existing immigration policies. So a draft of the agreement, which is not legally binding, was actually finalized in 2017 after more than a year of work, but at last they rejected for signing it. So as we know, Poland, the capital is Warsaw. The capital of Poland is Warsaw, and the currency of Poland is Polish zloty. Polish zloty. Which of the following state planned for construction of 80 feet Buddha statue? Gujarat. After the 182 meter tall statue of unity of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Gujarat is planning for a gigantic Buddha statue. So this is going to be around 80 feet high. So this is going to come up in Gandhinagar. Which state government celebrated the Sangai Tourism Festival recently? Manipur. So the annual Sangai Festival was celebrated in northeastern state of Manipur recently. This is a grandest festival of the state. Sangai is the name of the state animal of Manipur. It is now a critically endangered antlered deer that is found only in Manipur. So the festival, it aims to promote Manipur as a world-class tourism destination. So this festival is quite important. So it was inaugurated by Union Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman as well. Which of the following government entity has approved the expansion of the scope of mandatory packaging of 100% food grains? Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. It has approved the expansion of the scope of mandatory packaging of 100% food grains. This is actually under Jute Packaging Material Act 1987. Which company's next billion users has announced the rollout of its neighborly app across India? It is Google. Google has begun to rolling out neighborly app across Indian cities. This app, it is going to help people by sourcing local information from their neighbors. It will be first launched in Delhi and later on in cities like Chennai, Hyderabad, Pune and Kolkata. The full-fledged app it offers in 8 vernacular languages, and it is a targeted app with a geographic radius between 1 to 5 kilometers. So neighborly app is going to come across. It is going to be introduced by Google. Which country launched second Earth observation satellite Mohammed 6B? Morocco. Morocco has launched second Earth observation satellite Mohammed 6B. The first satellite Mohammed 6A, it was launched in 2017 November. So now this is the second Earth observation satellite Mohammed 6B. Morocco is taking the assistance of France for launching these satellites. It is on a 5-year program to be supported by France's Airbus, etc. Who is appointed as the first youth advocate of Northeastern region by UNICEF? Nahid Afrin is appointed as the first youth advocate of Northeastern region by UNICEF. Nahid Afrin is a singer, popular Indian singer of Assam. Nahid has made her playback debut in 2016 in the Bollywood film Akira, starring Sonakshi Sinha. So for this movie, she received the Best Female Playback Singer at Assam State Film Award 2018. So singer Nahid Afrin has been appointed as the first youth advocate of Northeastern region by UNICEF. Who is appointed as head of WhatsApp India? Abhijit Bose has been appointed as the head of WhatsApp India. Neeraj Arora has resigned. So Abhijit Bose is the new WhatsApp head of India. Who won the Forbes India Leadership Lifetime Achievement Award 2018? Azim Premji has won the Forbes India Leadership Lifetime Achievement Award 2018. As we know, Azim Premji is the head of Wipro. Wipro is the India's fourth biggest software services company in terms of revenue, and Azim Premji is the second richest man in India. The Forbes India Leadership Awards, they are the most prestigious honor for the top executives, and they are recently held in Mumbai. So in these awards, the Forbes India Leadership Lifetime Achievement Award 2018 was given to Azim Premji. Who won the Mexican Order of the Aztec Eagle, which is the highest civilian honor given to a foreigner by Mexico? Professor S.P. Ganguly, Shyama Prasad Ganguly. Shyama Prasad Ganguly has won the highest civilian honor of Mexico Order of Aztec Eagle. Professor S.P. Ganguly, he is a well-known Hispanist, headed the Center for Spanish and Latin American Studies at Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. He has been awarded this one. The award was given in the recognition of his outstanding work in the study of Spanish language and Mexican culture. So for his studies in Spanish language and Mexican culture, he was bestowed this award. When is the National Milk Day celebrated in India? National Milk Day celebrated on 26th of November every year to mark the birth anniversary of India's most successful dairy entrepreneur, Dr. Varghese Kurian. Dr. Varghese Kurian is the founder of dairy farm Amul, and he is responsible for the white revolution in milk. So National Milk Day is celebrated to remember him. So his birth anniversary is celebrated as National Milk Day on November 26th. When was the National Law Day or Indian Constitutional Day celebrated? It is also celebrated on November 26th. The National Law Day is celebrated on 26th of November to commemorate the adoption of Constitution of India. So Constitution of India was adopted on November 26th. This is also known as Samvidhan Divas. As we know, in Hindi we call the Constitution as Samvidhan. So Constitutional Day is called as Samvidhan Divas. On this day in 1949, the Constitution was adopted by the Constituent Assembly of India. So therefore it came into force on 26th January 1950. Therefore, it marked the beginning of a new era in the history of India. So therefore, this day is observed as Samvidhan Divas. Which state cabinet has approved renaming of Dehradun's Jolly Grant Airport after the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand government, chaired by Chief Minister Trivendra Singh Rawat, has approved Dehradun Airport to be renamed after the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. The government will infuse 42,000 crore rupees in the state-owned banks by March end. How much total amount was announced by the government for capital infusion program in October 2017? 2.11 lakh rupees. The government is going to infuse 42,000 crore rupees by March end in the next tranche. So the government earlier, it has pumped 11,336 crore rupees in 5 public sector banks, that is Punjab National Bank, Allahabad Bank, Indian Overseas Bank, Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank, to improve their financial health. Now the government has announced that it is going to further pump in 42,000 crores. So earlier in October 2017, it announced that 2.11 lakh crores will be pumped into the system as a part of capital infusion program. The International Cricket Council has announced that it has renamed ICC World T20 as ICC T20 World Cup. ICC T20 World Cup. So this changes will be applicable to both men's and as well as women's cricket. So the next edition of the events are going to be held in Australia in 2020. So T20 is going to be held in 2020 in Australia. And ICC is going to launch global cricket strategy in 2019. ICC is going to launch global cricket strategy in 2019. Who won the silver medal in women's feather category at International Boxing Association Women's World Boxing Championship 2018 in New Delhi? Sonia Chahal. Sonia Chahal has won silver. She has been defeated by German player Ornella Warner. So Sonia Chahal has won silver in 57 kg category. Who became the first player to pick up a hat-trick in the history of cricket's newest format T10 league? Praveen Tambi. So Praveen Tambi, who is an Indian cricketer, has become the first player to pick up a hat-trick in the history of cricket's newest format T10 league. Which country won the Women's World T20 2018 title? Australia. Australia has defeated England and has won the Women's World in 2020 title 2018. So this was hosted by West Indies. The match was hosted by West Indies. Who won the gold medal in the Sabre event in Senior Commonwealth Fencing Championship 2018, which was held in Canberra, Australia? Bhavani Devi. India's Bhavani Devi became the first Indian who has won a gold medal in the Sabre event in the Senior Commonwealth Fencing Championship 2018 in Canberra, Australia. Who has been named as the captain of the ICC Women's World T20 11? Harmanpreet Kaur. Harmanpreet Kaur has been named as the captain of ICC Women's World T20 11. Who became the fastest to complete the 200 wickets and 3000 runs in the Test cricket? Bangladesh Test captain and left arm spinner Shakib Al Hasan has become the fastest to complete the double of 200 wickets and 3000 runs in the test format of the game. He also became the first Bangladeshi bowler to claim 200 test wickets. When was the World Evolution Day celebrated? To commemorate the anniversary of the initial publication of Origin of Species by Charles Darwin, November 24th. The initial publications of Origin of Species by Charles Darwin was published on 24th November 1859. So to commemorate that day, every year the day is celebrated as World Evolution Day. Which of the following country was standing between Theresa May and Brexit deal as it threatened to derail an EU summit? Spain. So Spain is threatening to reject Theresa May's Brexit deal over Gibraltar. So Spain is standing between Theresa May and Brexit deal as it threatened to derail an EU summit to get some new assurances. As we know, the capital of Spain is Madrid and the currency is Euro. Name the first Sikh Guru whose 549th birth anniversary celebrated on 24th November. Guru Nanak. November 24th, it marks the birth of first Sikh Guru, Guru Nanak, who laid the foundation of Sikhism. So Kartika Purnima is celebrated as his birthday every year. Which of the following country calls for the Muslims to unite against United States? Iran. Iran's Rouhani, the head president of Iran, has called all the Muslims to unite against United States. What is the motto of National NCC Day, which is celebrated on 25th November? Unity and discipline. The motto of National NCC Day, celebrated on 25th November, is unity and discipline. So the motto for the NCC is unity and discipline. NCC, which means National Cadet Corps, it is celebrated on every fourth Sunday in the month of November. So fourth Sunday of November is celebrated as NCC Day. The NCC in India, it was formed by NCC Act, National Cadet Corps Act 1948, on 15 July 1948. The then first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, he presided over the function, raising the first NCC unit on the last Sunday of November 1948. So therefore, the fourth Sunday of November 1948 every year is celebrated as National NCC Day. The Oscar of Sports, Laureus World Sports Awards, will be held in Monaco in 2019. It is a sports premier global award ceremony. 8 individual and team categories awards will be given away. What is the theme of International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against the Women, which is observed on 25th November 2018? Orange the World. Orange the World is a theme of International Day for Elimination of Violence Against the Women. So the aim of this day is actually to raise awareness of the fact that women around the world are subject to rape and domestic violence and other forms of violence. So what is the violence in all forms faced by women will be discussed and exposed this day. So awareness about this will be brought. So the theme of this year is Orange the World. Which of the following district in Uttar Pradesh was granted the Export Excellence Tag for the product category? Carpet City, Bhadohi District, gets Export Excellence Tag for benefit artisans and boost shipments. It is very well known for hand woven carpets around the world, and therefore a excellence tag for the product category of carpets and other floor coverings by Director General of Foreign Trade under the Commerce Ministry was given to Bhadohi. Ministry of Finance increased the outlay for the first phase of the faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electrical vehicles scheme to how many crores? 895 crores. So the Ministry of Finance, they have increased 100 crores in the outlay. So total 895 crores will be given for the first phase of adoption of FAME India scheme. FAME India scheme, which means faster adoption and manufacturing of electrical vehicles. SpaceX will send humans for the first time in 8 years through SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule for commercial crew program, in collaboration with which space agency? NASA, National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, and SpaceX, both of them are preparing to launch a historic test flight to space. So it is geared up to send humans for the first time in 8 years through SpaceX Crew Dragon. So as a part of this, the space agency will first shoot out a test flight in January 2019. The SpaceX Crew Dragon can seat 3 astronauts, but will be unpiloted for its first test flight. Which star system is discovered by scientists in the Milky Way galaxy recently? Pinwheel. Scientists have discovered new pinwheel star system. So they have discovered a massive star system in Milky Way galaxy. This is going to challenge the existing theories related to death of big stars. Which Indian organization has developed a new technology impact-based forecasting approach to monitor impact of rain and deal with natural disasters? IMD, Indian Meteorological Department. So Indian Meteorological Department has developed a new technology called impact-based forecasting approach. This is to assess the rise of water level in rivers and reservoirs by rain. So it will help to avoid any disastrous situation which is similar to Kerala floods, and it can generate scenarios to help take decisions and release water or not from the reservoirs after a heavy downpour. So it is going to help every state authority to take this decision. Roscosmos, or Russia's state space corporation, has planned to venture into the Internet of Things with the launch of a new satellite system named Marathon. So where is the headquarters of Roscosmos located? Moscow. Russia is to venture into Internet of Things with new satellite system. So as we know, Roscosmos is Russia's state space corporation. Like we have ISRO, it is Roscosmos for Russia. So it has planned to venture into the Internet of Things with the launch of a new satellite system called as Marathon. So this will be fully established by 2026. So in this context, we need to know where is the Russian state space corporation Roscosmos headquarters. It is in Moscow. Name the Sangeet Natak Academy awardee and noted musician who have passed away recently. Ustad Imrat Khan. He was a classical musician, noted classical musician. He has passed away recently. He is a musical virtuoso of sitar and sur bahar. In 1988, Imrat Khan has received a Sangeet Natak Academy Award from President of India. He was also conferred with Padma Shri in 2017. But he refused to accept the award, stating it is too little and came little too late. For the first time in its history of Apollo Tyres, has appointed whom as its brand ambassador? It is Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Apollo Tyres. Didier Drogba announced his retirement after 20 years of his career. He belongs to which sport? Football. Former Chelsea striker Didier Drogba has announced his retirement after a career of 20 years. He has began his career at the French side in 1998. He has made 100 appearances on behalf of Ivory Coast, and he has also been voted for African Footballer of the Year twice. He also has won Premier League Golden Boot for 2006-07 and also 2009-10. Former Union Minister and actor Ambarish has passed away recently. He is known as Rebel Star. Ambarish's original name is Gowda Amarnath, so his screen name is Ambarish. He was an Indian actor, a media personality, a politician from a state of Karnataka. He belongs to the state of Karnataka. Alongside Rajkumar and Vishnuvardhan, he is counted in Kannada cinema's triumvirate in Best of Celebrated Actors. He worked as Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting. He was a Lok Sabha member from the constituency of Mandya. Well-known actress, Telugu actress Sumalata is his wife. Who was announced to be the recipient of Kuncha Kala Tapaswi Award in the category of Lifetime Achievement? A.N. Patil. A.N. Patil to be conferred with Kuncha Kala Tapaswi Award for his Lifetime Achievement. He is a senior artist. He is given in the category of Lifetime Achievement. Who was appointed as brand ambassador of food delivery platform Uber Eats? Alia Bhatt. Alia Bhatt has been appointed as the first brand ambassador of Indian Uber Eats. So India will be the first country where a global company appointed an ambassador for its product. So Uber Eats was launched in May 2017 and is currently present across 37 cities across India. So Alia Bhatt was also appointed as brand ambassador of Nokia early, and now Uber Eats is the second organization. Parent organization of Uber Eats is Uber, which was founded in August 2014. Which Indian actor led India to achieve a new Guinness World Record for most people holding the abdominal plank position at the Bajaj Allianz Life Plankathon in Pune? Shilpa Shetty Kundra has achieved a new spot in Guinness World Records of 2,353 people, led by Bollywood actress and fitness enthusiast, held the abdominal plank position for 60 seconds. The initiative was organized by Bajaj Allianz. India set the new world-breaking record, where earlier it was held in China, where 1,779 people, they held a plank for 60 seconds. Now India has defeated that record. C.K. Jafar Sharif has passed away in Bengaluru on 25th November. He is related to which field? He is a politician. He held the office of Minister of Railways under P.V. Narasimha Rao cabinet from 1991 to 1995. He also served as Minister of State for Railways. He handled several other central union portfolios like coal and irrigation also. Sharif has served as 7 terms as Member of Parliament of Lok Sabha. So C.K. Jafar Sharif has passed away in Bengaluru. He is a politician. The International Film Festival of India has nominated 12 movies for 2018. International Council for Film, Television and Audio-Visual Communication, UNESCO Gandhi Medal. Where is the headquarters of ICFT? The headquarters of ICFT is in Paris. So International Film Festival of India, it has nominated 12 movies for International Council for Film, Television and Audio Visual Communication, UNESCO Gandhi Medal. Of these 12 films, 2 films are from India, so hence it is in the news. So what are the 2 films? Tamil film Bharam and Ladakhi film Walking with the Wind. Both of them were nominated by IFFI from Indian side. Which state government has launched Women Empowerment Resolution Campaign? Uttar Pradesh government. Uttar Pradesh government has launched Women Empowerment Resolution Campaign to develop leadership capacities in women and make them vocal for their rights. It was launched by Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanand. So the purpose of this campaign is to ensure that empowerment of women through different programs in the state. Which 2 cities were selected by United Nations to participate in its Global Sustainable Cities 2025 initiative? Uttar Pradesh's Noida and Greater Noida were selected to participate in its Global Sustainable Cities 2025 initiative. They have been chosen under the University City category. Overall, 25 cities across the world have been selected in 5 categories under United Nations Global Sustainable Goals Initiative. The Sustainable Development Goals are a universal call to action to end poverty, protect the planet and ensure that all the people will enjoy peace and prosperity. Which regional airlines Udaan license was cancelled by the Airport Authority of India? Air Odisha. So under Udaan license of Air Odisha was cancelled by the Airports Authority of India. Udaan, as we know, it is Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. So under this, Air Odisha license was cancelled for 7 airports due to poor performance. The illustrated history of Indian hockey, a saga of triumph, pain and dreams, book was authored by V. Krishna Swami. So the illustrated history of Indian hockey, a saga of triumph, pain and dreams book was authored by V. Krishna Swami. So this book, it deals about various issues. What were the important events that have happened in hockey? The background data, in-depth information, including the World Cups, Asian Games and Commonwealth Games, all these were included in this book. It is authored by V. Krishna Swami. Jangal Mahal Festival to revive and popularize the culture and heritage of Jangal Mahal was celebrated in West Bengal. Jangal Mangal Festival is a 3-day annual event. It is celebrated in West Bengal and it is organized by Jangal Mahal Udyog. It is a festival that aims to revive and popularize the culture and heritage of Jangal Mahal. Where was the 10-day long Bali Yatra Festival inaugurated? The historic Bali Yatra Festival was inaugurated in Cuttack of Odisha on the occasion of Kartika Purnima. This is a 10-day long festival and this is said to be the largest trade fair in Orissa. It is held on the banks of Mahanadi River in Cuttack. Jirri Mela, a week-long annual festival, was inaugurated in Jirri village of which state? Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir governor has inaugurated annual week-long Jirri Mela festival in Jammu. This annual fair, it is celebrated as a commemoration to the memory of a martyred farmer named Baba Jittu. Cultural programs comprising of folk songs and Dogri dance is presented on the eve of this festival as well. Which bank was bought under the purview of Right to Action Act recently? As per Central Vigilance Commissioner guidelines and state legislature, Jammu and Kashmir Bank. Jammu and Kashmir Bank has recently bought under the purview of Right to Information Act. In which of the following category, MC Mary Kom has won her 6th boxing world title by clinching gold at 2018 AIBA Women's World Boxing Championship, which was held in New Delhi, 48 kgs category. So MC Mary Kom has recently created history by becoming the first woman to win 6 world boxing titles by clinching in the 48 kgs category at the 2018 AIBA Women's World Boxing Championship. Which company presents the world's first GST calculator, customized and loaded with features made just for the Indian market? Casio India. So Casio India, it has announced the launch of the world's first GST calculator. It is customized only for India. So Casio India is introducing 2 new innovations. The name of them is MJ120 GST and MJ12 GST. This calculator is equipped to navigate the challenging environment and smooth functionality by easing the issues faced by Indian retailers post the introduction of GST. So GST features will be embedded into this technology. India's first stadium of international standard for differently abled persons will be set up in Meghalaya. With a budget of 200 crores, a stadium is going to come up in Meghalaya, specially for the differently abled persons. Which of the following ministry has launched a national festival for children of child care institutions, Hosla 2018? So child care implies Ministry of Women and Child Development. So Ministry of Women and Child Development, they have launched National Festival for Children of Child Care Institutions, Hosla 2018. It has seen the participation of 600 children across 18 states. The theme for the event was child safety. The theme for this event was child safety. With which country India signed a protocol to amend the Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement for the avoidance of double taxation and prevention of fiscal evasion with respect to taxes on income? So Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement was signed by India recently with China. Already we have a DTAA with China, but that has been amended with respect to taxes on income. Where was the 5-day exhibition on Our Vote, Our Future was inaugurated by Dr. Rajat Kumar? It was inaugurated in Telangana, Hyderabad. Dr. Rajat Kumar is Chief Electoral Officer of Telangana. So he has inaugurated a 5-day exhibition on Our Vote, Our Future in Hyderabad. So what is the aim of the exhibition is to encourage people to increase the polling percentage. National Projects Construction Corporation Limited, NPCC, has been conferred with the status of Mini Ratna recently. So who is the present chairman and managing director of NPCC? Manohar Kumar. Manohar Kumar is the NPCC chairman and managing director. Mini Ratna status has been given to NPCC. Name the state government that released lexicons of 21 tribal languages for multilingual education purposes for elementary schools in tribal dominated districts. Odisha. So Odisha government has launched lexicons of 21 tribal languages for multilingual education purposes for elementary schools. This is a step towards tribal proficiency. It is going to help in better connectivity with the government functionaries and also tribal communities. India Autism Center, in association with which state, will be building a world-class autism township at a cost of 500 crores. West Bengal. So a non-profit organization named India Autism Center, in association with the West Bengal state government, they are going to construct a autism center near Kolkata with a cost of 500 crores. It is going to come up in a 52-acre plot land in the next 5 years. The book Making of New India, Transformation Under Modi Government was released by Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has released the book. It contains 51 essays on the themes ranging from economy to diplomacy, education to public health. With which country India signed protocol on hygiene requirements for export of fish meal and fish oil? India and China. India and China, they inked protocol on hygiene and inspection requirements for exports. So this is going to enable India to commence export of fish meal and fish oil to China. Which of the following states has organized International Geeta Festival recently? Haryana. Haryana government has recently organized International Geeta Festival 2018 at a place called Kurukshetra in Haryana. It is being organized to commemorate the birth of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Who won the bronze medal in under 21 men's singles category in the International Table Tennis Federation Challenge Belgostrak Belarus Open held in Minsk, Belarus? Manav Thakkar. India's Manav Thakkar settled for bronze in under 21 singles category in ITTF International Table Tennis Federation Challenge Belgostrak Belarus Open, which was held in Minsk, Belarus. So the gold was won by Zhou Jihua of China. Which city is the venue of the first ever Sustainable Blue Economy Conference 2018? Nairobi, Kenya. The theme of Sustainable Blue Economy Conference 2018 this year is Blue Economy and 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. Blue Economy and 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. The Sustainable Blue Economy Conference, it was built on the momentum of United Nations 2030 Agenda. So from India, Union Minister for Shipping, Road Transport and Highways, Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Regeneration, Nitin Gadkari has participated in the event. According to the fresh guidelines issued by BCCI, a cricketer guilty of age fraud would have to face a ban for how many years? 2 years. If a player is disqualified and barred on the grounds of age, he will be banned for 2 years. Which country won the Women's Hockey Champions Trophy 2018 held at Wuhan, China? Netherlands. So Netherlands has won the FIH Women's Hockey Champions Trophy, which was held at Wuhan, China. It is their 7th title. Which country has won the 2018 Davis Cup Tennis Tournament? Croatia. Croatia has defeated the defending champion France in the finals and has won the 2018 Davis Cup. This is the second time for Croatia after 2005. So Davis Cup, it is an international team event in men's tennis. It is run by International Tennis Federation and it is contested annually between teams from competing countries. Which city is the venue of 14th edition of Hockey World Cup 2018? Bhubaneswar. Bhubaneswar is the venue of Hockey World Cup 2018. The music for the song of Hockey World Cup 2018 was composed by A.R. Rahman. And the anthem features Shah Rukh Khan. The lyrics were penned by the Bollywood lyricist Gulzar. And the theme track was titled as Jai Hind, Jai India. Jai Hind, Jai India. President Ramnath Kovind inaugurated the second International Ambedkar Conclave in New Delhi. The second Ambedkar Conclave was inaugurated in New Delhi by President of India Shri Ramnath. So the conclave is being organized by the Forum of SC and ST legislators and parliamentarians and the Ambedkar Chamber of Commerce. Which country will chair the Kimberley Process Certification Scheme plenary in January 2019? India is going to chair Kimberley Process from 1st January 2019. So 15th Kimberley Process Certification Scheme plenary 2018 was held in Brussels, Belgium. So EU has handed over the chairmanship of KPCS to India from 1st January 2019. What is this KPCS? It is a process which was established in 2000 to prevent conflict diamonds from entering the mainstream rough diamonds market by United Nations General Assembly through a resolution following recommendations of Fowler report. India is going to chair the Kimberley Process Certification Scheme from January 1st, 2019. Who retained his title as World Chess Championship after beating his opponent Fabiano Caruana at the World Chess Championship in London? Magnus Carlsen. Magnus Carlsen has retained his title. Chess Championship was won by Magnus Carlsen thrice this year. Who won the Syed Modi International Badminton Championship men's singles title? Sameer Verma. Sameer Verma of India has won the men's single title by defeating China player. Saina Nehwal has won silver. And India's Satvik Sai Raj and Ranki Reddy, both of them, they have won silver at men's double event. And in Indian women's pair, Ashwini Ponnappa and Reddy and Sikki, both of them, they have won silver medal in women's double event. Who won the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix title 2018? Lewis Hamilton. Lewis Hamilton has won the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. This is his 11th win of this year's campaign. The Reserve Bank has relaxed norms for external commercial borrowings, ECBs, by reducing the mandatory hedging provision from 100% to how much percent? 70%. External commercial borrowings, these are loans in India made by non-resident lenders in foreign currencies to Indian borrowers. They are widely used in India to facilitate access to foreign money by Indian corporations and public sector units. So the Reserve Bank, it has relaxed the norms for external commercial borrowings by reducing the mandatory hedging provision from 100% to 70%. CSIR to establish a high-end skill development center in which place? Chandigarh. CSIR is to establish a high-end skill development center in Chandigarh. Which law was imposed by Ukraine's parliament in the country to fight growing aggression from Moscow? Martial law. So Ukraine has declared martial law after Russian naval attack. Which country government has launched a social security scheme for formal sector workers? Nepal. Nepal government, it has launched a social security scheme for formal sector workers. The new social security scheme, it is a contribution based and it will cover health and medical facilities, safe motherhood, accident and physical incapacity security, and security to dependent family members, etc. Which day is observed as International Day of Solidarity with the Palestinian people? It is 29th November. 29th November is observed as International Day of Solidarity with the Palestinian people. The General Assembly, it has declared it in 1977. Which university to be renamed as Rani Rashmoni Green University? West Bengal Green University. So West Bengal Green University is going to be renamed as Rani Rashmoni Green University. To commemorate the birth anniversary of Rani Rashmoni, so this year it is 225th birth anniversary, so they are going to rename the university as such. Third Inclusive Wealth Report 2018 is released by the United Nations Environment in Paris, France. So the United Nations Environment has released a third edition of Inclusive Wealth Report in France. According to the preliminary finding, Republic of Korea, Singapore and Malta, they have topped the chart of biennial survey of growth in the wealth of nations. Which country parliament has passed a motion to repeal age limit of presidential candidacy? Maldives. Maldives parliament has passed a motion to repeal age limit of presidential candidacy. What is the theme of Indian International Trade Fair 2018? Entrepreneurs of Rural India. Entrepreneurs of Rural India. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanand has unveiled final details of the construction of how many meters length of Ram statue in Ayodhya? 221 meters. So the height of Ram statue which is going to be constructed in Ayodhya is going to be 221 meters. On which day the 14th formation day of National Disaster Management Authority was inaugurated by the Minister of State for Home Affairs Kiran Rijiju? 27th November. So the Minister of State for Home Affairs Kiran Rijiju has inaugurated the 14th Formation Day National Disaster Management Authority NDMA on 27th November 2018 in New Delhi. The theme of this year Formation Day is Early Warning for Disasters. Early Warning for Disasters. Name the NASA spacecraft, the first robotic lander designed to study the deep interior of a distinct world that touched down safely on the surface of Mars. It is InSight. So now the name of the NASA spacecraft, which is the first robotic lander to Mars, which touched down safely on the surface of Mars, is InSight. That's all in the month of November. We're coming up with a November monthly bulletin, so please go through it as well. Thank you.